Hello, I'm Thorsten Anders, and this video is part of a series of videos for the unit Algorithmic Composition at the University of Bedfordshire. These videos introduce the Algorithmic Composition System and Programming Language, PWGL. This system has originally been developed at the Sibelius Academy by a team around Michael Lawson. In this particular video, we are looking at the very basics, doing the very first steps with the environment PWGL, learning the very first steps of this programming language. When you open the application, you see two windows. There's one patch window, and there's an output window. And the patching window is there to create our programs. And we add objects, we add language elements to the patching window by pressing Control and then click. Yeah, that's just the context menu, or you can do also right click. And that way, then you see there's just a menu with lots of entries. And for now, we go to data and select num box. And there we have our first box. If I'm hovering with a mouse here, you can see that the mouse becomes all sorts of different shapes depending on where we are. And that's a way to access different functions. We will later see what that is. And one of these functions is if I'm hovering over the title, then I can grab this box, I click it, and for example, drag it along if I keep it clicked. Or I can just select it, yeah, like this by clicking on the title. Now, this is a number box, I can enter numbers. If you see, if I'm with a mouse in the middle of the box, I can just click it and then drag it up and down, and you see it change numbers like that. I can also just double click and enter a value if I want. Okay, now let's add another box. Again, Control, click, or right click. And I go this time to the arithmetic menu and select this G plus there. That's a plus box, a plus function. So I'm just aligning those slightly. And now, for the first time, I'm connecting two boxes. I go to the outlet of this box, click, keep click, and go to the inlet of the second box and let go. And there we have a connection. If I later want to remove a connection, I can hover with the mouse over the connection, click, then it's selected, and I do backspace and it's removed. Okay, again, I go to the outlet of one box, drag it to the index of another box and let go, and there we have a connection. Now, this would add, that's an adding, addition, this would add the number 1 to whatever we enter here. So, for example, number 1 added to 3 would be 4. Now, how do we evaluate this? How do we get the result? I select a box by clicking the title, or by, I can also swipe, select, or yeah, click the title. And then I press a short key, and this short key is perhaps the most important key you just need to remember from the beginning. That's a short key for evaluate. Evaluate, it's a V, pressing a V. And then you see here in the output box, we see it shows the result, which is a 4. So again, if I select, for example, this one and press V, then it shows the result is the input, that's 1. If I want to change it, yeah, again, I can change as before. Say, now I add 5 and 3, select it, press V for evaluate, and 5 and 3, and R. Okay, now what we did so far was adding boxes, connecting them and evaluating them. And this is a simple but it's already a complete computer program, so we may want to save it. And saving does work like in any other Mac application, pretty much. Yeah, you go to File and then Save. And yeah, or you do Save As and save it whatever you want. Yeah. What's important is that you keep this extension PWGL added, PWGL. If that's missing, then the system, the operating system, will not recognize that this is a PWGL patch and not doesn't quite know what to do with that. Okay. Now, with our menu, now remember, right-click, and then we can bring up whatever. For example, this one. There are very many boxes, and first, you don't know what they do. There are different ways to get documentation, but one I'll show you right away, and that is adding a box and then pressing the letter D, D for documentation. And then up pops this documentation box where it just very briefly tells you what this box does. Here the main line is, just this PWGL version of. And then that is the multiply sign. So that is perhaps over concise, but basically it says that this box does multiplication. Likewise, if you select this one, so press D, then we get PWGL version of plus. Yeah, so this does multiply, just to show this does indeed multiply. If you enter 2 here and we enter 3 here, then this calculates 2 times 3, which is 6. There, the result is 6. Okay, now, with this menu going back, with arithmetic, you have a lot of other boxes that do various computations with numbers. Yeah, so we have addition, we have subtraction, yeah, minus, multiplication, division, and then power. So 2 to the power of 3, for example, is 2 times 2, yeah, would be 4, and so on. With rounding, yeah, just to briefly demonstrate rounding, if we have, for example, the number 3.14 point. Just to make absolutely sure there's a point there. If we round this, then it's just 3. Yeah, so it takes out the fractional part. Or in PWGL, we can use directly fractions if we want. Yeah, we can, for example, have 5/2. Yeah, that's actually as allowed as a number input. I just make this a bit bigger. I go turn this into a cross, make it a bit bigger. So you can see this is now 5/2. If I round this, 5/2 is 4.5, and rounded, it's 2.5, obviously, and rounded, it is then 2. Now, so far, we just use PWGL basically as a pocket calculator, and that's not very exciting yet. This is actually a system for generating music, for using computations to create music. So let's start with the first music-related object, and that is, I'll start here with a chord editor. And that brings up basically some simple notation that shows a chord, and I can play this by pressing the spacebar. And you hear, yeah, I can do that again. It just plays that note. Okay, how can I change this note? This is actually an editor, yeah. I can double click this and change it in here if I want to, for example. Yeah, and can later on show there are more ways, but for now, what we are interested in is in the unit algorithmic composition use algorithmic means to create music. And as a first step, let's just find a way how we enter numbers into the chord editor in order to make it show specific pitches we want. So we start again with a number box. Control click. And oops, it was the wrong one. And I have the number box here. So now the question is, which number represents which pitch? If you know the MIDI protocol, MIDI note numbers, the number 60 represents middle C. The number 61 is a semitone above, and so on. So let's go to 60. And connect this here, evaluate, and there we have middle C. If we want to have 61, then we have C sharp, and so on. Sometimes you may want to, as you can see, it's a chord editor. You may want to have more than one pitch at a time. And for that, we have another box here, and that is called value box. Values can be not only numbers, it's more flexible. And here by default, there's a list in there. I'll make this a little bigger, that you better see that. A list is anything which opens with a round parenthesis and closes with a round parenthesis. And yeah, so if I open round parenthesis and then put 60 in there for middle C, and then say, just for argument's sake, 64, which is the E above middle C, close the round parenthesis here. And I always need to press enter in order to close this box here. So if I have this, I press enter to enter this. Make sure. Yeah. Now I overwrite the input from the numbox. You see the numbox input goes away. And if I evaluate the chord editor now, you can see there are two notes in there. You can hardly see that. Now I can use my trackpad to swipe it pretty much like you do that on your mobile to increase this a little bit, and then you can better see. Now there are two notes. If I play, indeed, that's a major time. You can change that, for example, to C and G in the fifth, and so on. Yeah, just for argument's sake, turn that into a minor seventh. Okay. And now let's do the first computer program where we actually compute some pitch. So I take this all away and have again my chord editor. And this is the input. And I have another chord editor. And this is the output. What I want to do is I give this some input pitch and then some interval by which I want to transpose this in order to get some output pitch. Yeah, I want to have a little computer program that I can use to transpose individual pitches or chords. And transposition is simply done with a plus box. If I take the pitches, now if I want to see, yeah, we saw we can have an input of, for example, 60 to create, to control which pitch goes in there. We can also control which pitches are in there by selecting this output here. Yeah, not this one. You see, this is a box which has two outputs, but this one, if I press V now, then you see that outputs 60, but it outputs 60 in a list, yeah, open and close parenthesis, because it could be more pitches in the chord. And we use this pitch and enter that into our number box. And the number box, the other number box here, which is our interval, goes into the other number. And let's say I want to transpose this, whatever it's input there, I want to transpose that by a pure fifth, seven semitones, and the result of that goes into the other chord editor. And if I evaluate the second chord editor now by pressing V, you see, or C has been transposed by seven semitones to a fifth. I can do the same thing again by transposing it downwards. Now it transposed to an F below. Or, yeah, you can enter here pretty much whatever number you want. Let's say I transpose it by 12 semitones upwards, which is an octave up. And you can see here. And the whole patch works because this plus box can handle those lists. Yeah, it does not only add individual numbers, it can add numbers and lists of numbers. Just to make that even more explicit, I'll move this all down again and add the value box as we did before in order to add a chord. Now I make this again a bit bigger just to make it a bit more visible what we are doing here. And I add a C major chord here. 60 MIDI key number. 60 is middle C, 64 is E, and 67 is G. So that results in a C major chord. And if I want to transpose a C major chord by a semitone upwards, that's one semitone upwards, and I have a C sharp. Yeah, C and C sharp. Or I can have two semitones upwards, then I have D major, and so on. So in this video we briefly introduced how to create boxes in PWGL and then how to connect them, how to compute with numbers, and then how to use numbers for having the first music computation functions.